I did experience during the dialogues with myself is some very interesting and unusual imagery. Some of it was very dreamlike. Some of it was more, well, more psychedelic, sort of the classic sort of shapes and colors and shifting sensations.
M. Hanchek is describing his experience with psilocybin, the pharmaceutical version of the psychedelic substance magic mushrooms. It's a potentially groundbreaking medication for people with treatment-resistant depression, like M.
But my life is in a different place now.
M is one of 24 participants in a recent study here at the Johns Hopkins Center for Psychedelic and Consciousness Research.
For some people who've not found relief from the traditional therapies that are out there, this could indeed be life-saving.
Dr. Natalie Gukasian is the center's medical director.
The effects of the medication are usually evident pretty quickly, much more quickly than we see with standard antidepressants.
Hopkins study participants got two psilocybin pills. Each dose was 2 weeks apart. And 1 month later, 71% of participants had a clinically significant response, which means an improvement in their depression symptoms of 50% or more. 54% of participants, more than half, were in complete remission.
The next phase of the study involves those same participants a year later. The results have yet to be published, but Dr. Gukasian says they are impressive.
Essentially, it shows that the results that we saw at 1 month, surprisingly, were persistent through the one-year period, which was pretty remarkable.
Here's how the treatment works. First, participants are prepared for the experience over several counseling sessions, and then on treatment day, they're led into this comfortable room.
People lie back on the couch, you know, they have eye shades on, they have headphones on, playing a preset recording of music. And they're encouraged to go inward and to have the experience.
Two therapists are with them to offer support during the entire hallucinogenic experience, which lasts 4 to 6 hours.
And the psilocybin allows geographically distant and pretty, you know, functionally distinct areas of the brain to talk to one another when they normally wouldn't.
But Hopkins isn't the only local medical facility studying psilocybin.
We had somebody who spent a whole hour giggling, and we've also had somebody who spent hours crying.
Shepherd Pratt researchers are conducting a study that entails one dose. Dr. Scott Aronson calls his results stunning.
Ultimately, all my studies are a single dose of psilocybin and leading to often transformative results. So there certainly is a couple of people that we followed now for 12 weeks who remain in remission.
To illustrate what's happening, Dr. Aronson showed us this image. The left side is brain activity after placebo, the right side after psilocybin. See those additional lines? They are new connections in the brain.
What we're actually doing here is increasing neuronal connectivity, and it enables people to engage with their inner life in a different way than anything else has.
Dr. Aronson says psilocybin seems to unlock a door that allows psychotherapy to be more effective.
This is a whole different way to look at depression.
And Dr. Gukasian says for some, it's a whole different way of looking at their existence. She's intrigued by what some participants describe as a mystical experience.
Feeling one with nature and with the universe, sort of a loss of boundaries between self and other and things like that.
How? Where does that come from?
That we're still figuring out.
There's a lot scientists are still figuring out about psilocybin. It'll be another 5 or 6 years until it's available as a treatment. Larger studies still need to be done.
For M. Hanchek, improvements didn't happen right away, but over time, it allowed psychotherapy to have a much greater effect.
Going from someone who was previously holding himself back from engaging in life and coming out of it and being able to work towards somebody who is more open to experience and who is kinder to myself, and that translates to being kinder and more open with others.
Mindy Becerra, WBAL TV 11 News.
Researchers say this is just the beginning of psilocybin research into all kinds of psychological issues, including anxiety, anorexia, even autism. Shepherd Pratt is in the process of constructing an entire facility for psychedelic research in conjunction with the mental health care company Compass Pathways. Both Shepherd Pratt and Johns Hopkins are actively looking for study participants, and you can find a link to more information on WBALTV.com and link to our mobile app.